Hello friends, welcome to SETI Botany Classes. In this video, we will discuss about structure and functions of xylem. Xylem is part of vascular tissue. Vascular tissue is made up of phloem and xylem. Phloem helps in conduction of nutrients and xylem helps in conduction of water and minerals. Now, xylem is made up of four kinds of cells, tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. Now these are four kinds of cells present in the xylem. So because of these cells, xylem is also called as complex permanent tissues. Now these are the fibers, which are elongated and highly thickened, and these are tracheids, which are placed one upon each other, and vessels again placed one upon each other, and fourth kind of cells are parenchymatous cells, xylem parenchyma. First, we'll discuss about structure of tracheids. Tracheids, they are pointed and tapered at both the ends. Their length is about 5 to 6 mm. And in young condition, they will have protoplast, cell organelles, and nucleus. But at maturity, nucleus will not be found. Cell organelles will get degenerated and cytoplasm will also disappear. So almost tracheids, they will at maturity, they will become dead. They will be without any protoplast, without any nucleus, and they're placed one upon each other. And through these membranes, they are connected, and there is passage of water and minerals through the tracheids. Now, first form wall of the tracheid is called as primary wall, and these are the thickenings which are being deposited on the tracheids. But these thickenings, which are being deposited later on, this is also called as a secondary wall material. This may be made up of lignin. Lignin is a chemical. When it is being deposited, this is also called as lignification. Now, because of different kind of secondary wall material, tracheids are categorized into different categories. Now, if they are these thickenings, they are present in the form of a rings, then it is called as annular. But if thickenings are present in the form of a spiral like this, so these thickenings are spiral. So tracheids are called as spiral thickenings. And if these thickenings, they are forming a network, then tracheids are called as reticulate tracheids. Now, if these thickenings are in the form of bands, and these bands are lying transversely into the tracheids, it's appearing like a ladder. So this is called as scleriform. So depending upon thickening, tracheids, they are of four type: annular, spiral, reticulate, and scleriform. And fifth category is also there, which is called as pitted thickening. Now, pitted thickenings are like this is the primary wall of the tracheid. First formed wall is called as primary wall. But later on, the wall which is being deposited, again, I'll tell you, this is made up of lignin. So this is called a secondary wall material. Now, this is again thickening. This is thickening. But it is the unthickened area. Now, this unthickened area is also called as pit. And the membrane present in the pit is called as pit membrane. Now this will appear like rounded on the tracheids. So this is showing unthickened area on the tracheid. So this is the surface view of the tracheid. So this is tracheid with simple pitted thickenings. Now here we will see this is again primary wall and this is the secondary wall material, but it has borders at the end. So due to these borders, this is a small circular pore of unthickened area. This is the bigger pore of unthickened area. So bigger pore is from the center and small pore is from here. So this is tracheid with bordered pitted thickening. And this pit membrane may also have torus. This is again swelling present on the pit membrane. And this torus will act as a well, helping in checking the passage of water and minerals through the tracheids. So tracheids with bordered pitted thickening. And these are the tracheids with simple pitted thickening. We have already discussed thickenings in the tracheids, like in the form of rings, annular. And if it is in the form of spiral, and forming network reticulate, ladder-like scleriform, simple pitted thickening, and bordered pitted thickenings. Now these are the vessels, which are tube-like, and they are placed upon each other. So this is one vessel, this is second, and this is third. And so many vessels will be arranged from the root to the top of the plant. And if you see the structure of the vessels, they have comparatively broader, you can say, diameter, width as compared to tracheids, but they have a shorter length as compared to tracheids. Their end walls get dissolved at maturity to form perforation plates, and this is the end wall of the tracheids. So again, these are vessels placed one upon each other. And these are the vessels having end walls dissolved. And if there is simple single pore, this is called a simple perforation plate. And if it has multiple pore, this is called as a multiple perforation plate. So vessels also in young condition, they may have cytoplasm, but at maturity, they will lack cytoplasm. They will not have nucleus. So this will form a continuous unhindered passage for the movement of water and minerals from the root to the top of the plant. Now, this is showing thickening of the vessel membrane or vessel wall, primary wall, then secondary wall is deposited. Like in tracheids, we have shown different kind of thickening like annular, spiral, scleriform, reticulate, pitted. Pitted can be simple, it can be bordered. Similarly, wall of the vessel is also thickened like the tracheid. This may show annular, spiral, scleriform, reticulate, and pitted thickening. And these thickenings present on the vessel wall as well as tracheid wall, they also provide mechanical support. Like we have seen many tallest trees like eucalyptus and sequoia. Eucalyptus is the example in case of angiosperm, and sequoia is in case of gymnosperm. And in such tallest trees, from the root to the top of the plant, there's movement of water for water and minerals with the help of vessels. In case of angiosperm, more of the conduction of water and minerals occurs with the help of vessels. But in case of gymnosperm, it is more of with the tracheids. 95% vessels are found in angiosperm and 5% tracheids. But in case of gymnosperm, more of the tracheids and less of the vessels. Now, depending upon the distribution of the vessels in the secondary xylem, now it is categorized into two types, ring porous and diffuse porous. If the diameter of the vessels is different in different seasons, like in autumn season, they are very narrow diameter. And in case of spring season, more growth occurs and vessel diameter is more, indicating more supply of water and minerals to the plant. So there is variation in the diameter of the vessels in the autumn as well as in the spring season. So this is called as ring porous wood. But diffuse porous wood, in this case, plants growing in the areas where uniform growth is occurring throughout the year. So diameter of the vessel is also uniform. So this is called as diffuse porous wood. So ring porous wood, larger vessels are confined to the early wood, and vessels with short diameter with later formed wood. Diffuse porous wood, vessels with uniform diameter are distributed throughout the wood. Now, third kind of cells associated with xylem are xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma basically are made up of thin-walled cells. Cell wall is made up of cellulose, and they are compactly arranged cells. This is xylem parenchyma. This is also xylem parenchyma. If parenchyma is made up of one kind of cell, its condition is called as homocellular. But if there are two kind of cell, condition is called as heterocellular. That we'll discuss in the next videos. Now, function of the parenchyma is to store food, starch, oil, and other excretory products or encaustic substances. They are stored in the parenchyma tissue. Now, parenchyma tissue is found in the primary xylem as well as in the secondary xylem. First formed xylem in the plant is called as primary xylem, but later on formed xylem tissue in the plant is called as secondary xylem. And this xylem also provides elasticity to the thickened tracheids and vessels present in the xylem tissue. And a fourth kind of cells are xylem or wood fibers. Again, they are tapered and they are narrow. They have a very narrow lumen. This is the thickened wall of the xylem fibers. Now, again, they will not have any protoplast and nucleus. They are dead cells and they will provide mechanical strength and support to the xylem tracheids and vessels. And basically, these fibers, they are made up of thick wall tissues called as sclerenchymatous cells. And these fibers, they are categorized into two categories, fiber tracheids and libriform fibers. Now we'll discuss about functions of xylem. We have discussed different kind of cells found in the xylem, like xylem tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. In case of angiosperm or flowering plant, 95% vessels conduct water and minerals, 5% tracheids. In case of angiosperm, tracheids, they are an alternate and additional pathway for the movement of water and minerals. But in case of gymnosperms, 95% tracheids and 5% vessels, they will help in conduction of water and minerals. So main function of xylem is conduction of water and minerals. And this conduction of water and minerals will occur from the root, and root will take water and minerals from the soil. Now they will move to the top of the plant, branches, leaves, and various tissues of the plant with the help of vessels and tracheids. So tracheids and vessels, they are also called as tracheary elements, and they are the principal conducting cells. Tracheids and vessels, because their wall is lignified, thick, so they will provide mechanical support to the plant. And unthickened areas are also found in the tracheids. They will help in movement of water and minerals from one tracheid to the another tracheid. And torus present in the tracheids will act as a well. This will check the movement of water and minerals to the tracheids. Now we know that vessels and tracheids, they become dead at maturity. So they will form a continuous system for the movement of the water, unhindered passage movement of water and minerals from the root to the top of the plant, as well as to the branches, leaves, and various tissues of the plant. And tracheids and vessels will not collapse, will not degenerate, because they have a very hard lignified wall, and that will help in their long distance transport. Parenchyma cell will provide elasticity, flexibility to the tissue, and will also help in storage of the food. And this will also help in lateral translocation of the food, water, and minerals to the tissues. Xylem fibers, they will add strength and rigidity to the plant, and they will provide the mechanical support. They will act like pillar to the various cells of the xylem tissues. So main function of the xylem is conduction of water and minerals. This will also provide mechanical support to the plant, and parenchyma help with storage of the food, as well as lateral translocation of the water and minerals and food also to various tissues. So this is all about structure and functions of xylem. Now in the next videos, we will discuss different kind of xylem, like metaxylem, protoxylem, how they are arranged, what is exarch, endarch conditions, and how they are arranged in the steels. That we'll discuss in the next videos. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe.